Alright, what's up, guys? Also, what's up to the stream right now who's watching this live, still recording? So this video is going to be simple. This one is just about a technique that I've been asked about for a super long time. Everyone's been asking me to make a video of this. Just a simple bread and butter combo for the Marth, short hop double pair. So there's two different parts of this. Simply the short hop, which I hope you guys know how to do, just lightly press and jump, and then the aerials. So the important thing about this is actually speed. Speed is an important component of this, so that's why I've been hesitant about making a video. But, you know, with the speed comes the technique, or with the technique comes the speed, so first I do want to teach the technique of how I do this. So, in my opinion, there's three different kinds of short hop double pairs. So, simply enough, it's just relative to your jump arc. So, there's a jump forward short hop double pair, a jump neutral short hop double pair, and then a jump back short hop double pair. Just like that. And I want to talk about how I do each of them. So, lots of times, we'll talk about it from jump forward, jump neutral, then jump back. So first, jump forward, short hop double pair. Looks just like this. Oops. Just like that. So the way that I like to do my forward short hop double pair is actually, I like to do it two different ways. So the first one is jumping forward and doing two C-stick. So to do a forward air, I have awesome the luxury of either picking forward A or C-stick. And this one is C-stick. So the first thing that you want to get down is, you know, this goes for all three of the short hop double pairs, is getting your first forward air to auto-cancel. So you don't want to have to, you know, you don't want to land in your forward air landing lag like this. You know, see how I'm doing it late in my jump arc? You're going to want to do it early, so that you don't even have to L-cancel it. More importantly, you want to do it early so that you can fit in your other aerial, just like that. So first, get down just your neutral jump forward air. And once you get that, then you can start going forward with it. And it's going to be case by case. You know, do you like A, or do you like C-stick? I like C-stick. PPND likes A. So, you know, both of them are good. So the first thing you need to stress, as I said, was the first early forward air. So for C-stick, how I like to do it, I'll show my hands right here, is I like to just do this. Just two flicks. I don't need to be super fast to do this, actually. So just like this. This is forward air. Or this is with A. A is a bit easier because your first forward air is going to come out faster because your thumb is closer to A than it is to C-stick. So the difference here is when you do it with neutral jump. So the reason why I don't like to use A for a short hop double pair neutral jump is to do a short hop forward air, the input is I have to press forward. So naturally my character is also going to go forward when I do that input. So what I'm going to have to do is I like to just, for a neutral jump, I always like to use C-stick. PPMD still likes to use A, but he's crazy. What's up, Alvin?
What's up?
I'm doing the PewPewUniversity right now.
Sick.
So, the cool thing is that neutral jump gives you the most freedom, because after you do leave the ground, you can either choose to go forward or back or just straight neutral. So, with that, you know, sometimes you're, after the first forward air, you have to change your direction. So that's why I feel like it's best to use C-stick. Okay, now for a jump backwards. For a jump backwards short hop double pair, I suggest you don't touch A. This is my suggestion purely. As I said, PPMD likes A, but if you're jumping back, you don't want your input with A and forward to be influencing how your character moves in the air. So I feel you should always be using C-stick. So on my left hand, the only input that I'm actually doing for fade back is just right, going to the right if I'm facing left. And I think that's like a very simple way of doing it. and it might be more comfortable, and you might even be faster with it for A, but I do feel like you get the most control from using C-stick, and so this is what it's gonna look like. Just like that. I kind of run out of stage when I do it. But yeah, and I'll show my hands right here. So I got my hands right here. My left hand's very free. All I'm doing is going to the right, and then I use my C-stick for the rest of it. See, just like that. This is hard. See, just like this. I know, I'm just in a terrible position. But yeah, guys, this is short hop double fair. So, quick review, to get it down, just do the first short hop fair, make it snappy, put in that second one, and after you get that second one, start putting in your movement. I guarantee you, if you practice this 15 minutes a day, just really simple, you know, maybe even 10 minutes a day, you'll get it. So once again, this is about speed, guys. This is definitely about speed. It's not so much about technique, but now that you do know the technique, you can go ahead, put your speedonomics on it, whatever you guys want to call it. But I'll see you guys later.